Welcome to Knit One, Part 2,
Episode 195.
I'm Sheila, also known as Sheila D37.
And I'm Wendy, also known as Penny Winnie. Welcome back.
I'm back.
Yeah, Sheila's back. And if this is your first time viewing, or if last week was your first time viewing, normally we have two people on the show.
We're at my house today, which is the reason why we have a plain black grayish wall.
Yes, and I forgot how much trouble it was to lug everything to your house. I was like, oh, I gotta like pack everything up.
It's easier than me trying to go over to your house right now,
of course. But I just had, it's been a while, so I had forgotten how much I had to pack into my bag. So,
A few shout outs.
Yes.
So we finished up our knit along, our warmth knit along, and we're going to, we drew for a prize and we'll announce the winner of that prize at the end of the show. Yay. And we're announcing our new knit along, which we didn't look to see who gave us the idea, but somebody gave us the idea on our continuing thread of ideas. So please continue
throwing out ideas.
Patterns with 20 or less projects, little known patterns.
Yeah. So pick a pattern that doesn't have very many projects, less than 20.
And please, when you post the pattern, or when you post your picture, post a link or at least the name to the pattern so that we can verify it. It's going to be close, so say there's a pattern that's 18 and then four of you are doing it.
That's fine. That's fine. We get that, but
you know, don't pick a pattern that's already 30.
Right.
Or, you know, 25.
This way we can get some lesser known patterns out there. I'm pretty sure that this pattern had very few.
The pattern that I'm going to show later has only 16, and that's with me doing it. So that'll
finish up at the end of February, and we will draw it during the first show in March.
Yeah, because February is a short month. It's only 28 days.
And we are also drawing 6 winners for the Earth's Wonders patterns at the end of the show today.
And we also have,
we have a new contest that I'm very excited to tell you about. Knittingsmybag.
Lois.
Who is our friend Lois, has donated 3 bags with matching yarn.
That's awesome.
And I will, at the end of the show, we'll talk about it, but we're going to have a contest where over the next little while, we're doing one at a time, you can win the bag and
I'm assuming these are bags she's made.
She made the bags and she donated the yarn from her stash that matches.
So she picked out, she made the bag and she picked out yarns to match.
Yeah,
she or she picked out the yarns and made the bags to match, one or the other.
Yeah.
Nice.
It is nice. And they're really cute bags. So.
They are. I saw the prizes. They look good.
I know. So we will start that first, the contest for the first one of those at the end of the show.
All right.
And you go first this week.
I go first because I wasn't there last week. So I have one thing on the needles, and this is new because I started it last week. So this is a toe-up sock, and it's going to incorporate the fish lips kiss heel. I never say it right.
You got it.
Did I? So I'm using toe-ups. Let me show you my sock first. This is going to be for my son, who's got size 11 feet, I think. I've promised him some socks. This is Croy, Patton's Croy. And I think I'm going to have to buy another skein.
Yeah, you will.
Well, I was hoping what I could do. All right, anyways, this is Patton's Croy socks striped in the spring leaf stripes.
I want to get that now.
And I think I saw Susan B. Anderson do it on Instagram.
She did, and I liked it.
And I liked it. And then I wanted it, but I'm like, you know, I really didn't need a sock. And then my son picked it out for his sock. I'm like, well, that works well. Well, what happened, though, is they only had one in stock at the time.
Oh, so you...
And this is an A.C. Moore, Michaels, a big box store. So what I decided to do was the black toe, black heel, and black cuff. So what I might do is just knit this until I get to 50% of this. And this is a 50-gram ball.
Yeah.
50 grams, I believe. Yeah, 50-gram ball. And then do the rest in black.
That's a
good
50
idea. Grams. So I'm hoping I can at least get the foot in this color.
I think you probably will be.
And maybe a little bit of a cuff.
Yeah.
But I have to knit until about 8.5 inches before I can turn the heel on this thing. So I got about 2 more inches left. So we'll see. I love the feel of this for a, how do I want to call it, commercialized sock?
Yeah, commercially dyed.
It's a sturdy wool. I mean, this is a wool sock. It's not your
pure
merino, but this is going to be a sturdy sock, which for a growing boy, you need that.
Yeah.
And I made the rag wool with
And I had my mom made them yeah. for me. Yeah.
And it's held up really well.
Yeah, those are some of my favorite socks.
Yeah, it really keeps your feet warm. As a matter of fact, I think Max stole them from me. Not stole them, borrowed them over the weekend for the snowstorm because they do keep your feet warm. And I keep trying to tell my husband. He doesn't understand wool socks. My feet are cold. Wear wool socks.
I know.
Why? Because when they're wet, when wool is wet, it still keeps you warm.
Yes.
That's the whole idea of wool. Anyways, that's all I have on the needles, believe it or not, is this. And this I started, I think, just so you know, Friday. Mm-hmm. I have not been knitting on it completely, because you'll see why. But I did most of this in 2 days.
Cool.
Yeah.
On my needles, the first thing that I have on my needles is my Bucilla Christmas sock, which I didn't bother to bring with me because I don't have much progress on it, and it was just like another extra bag, so I left it at home. But if
what's the Bucilla Christmas sock?
The one with the Santa that I'm making.
Oh, the stocking.
The Christmas stocking.
Sorry.
That you can look at on last week's episode. Maybe one row.
Oh, right.
It just was like, it didn't fit in the bag that I was bringing, and I was like, I'm not bringing it, it's too much. So that's at home. But you can see it on my project page, and I showed it last week. The next thing that I have on the dance card is a self-striping sock out, toe up, out of Fiber Nymph Dye Works Sad Panda colorway, which I love. I love how the striping is variegated on this. I just think that's cool. Reminds me of winter a little bit.
Yeah.
I like it. And it's on the bedazzle base. You can't really see too well. Well, you can now. It's sparkly, which I love. I love this base. I love the way it feels when it knits up. It feels so nice. And I am using the Rise and Shine patterning. I did not follow the actual Rise and Shine sock pattern because they do a construction that I am not interested in doing. But I took the stitch pattern, which is these zigzags, and I'm doing one direction for one side, and I mirrored it on the other side by starting the chart, reading the chart opposite. Which is how
and
a good way.
This is a free pattern, right?
This all is of your a striping, free pattern. Striping I try patterns. To find free patterns yeah. for socks. In large part for me, because honestly, if it's a stitch pattern like this, if I wanted to, I could just do it myself. Yeah. But I don't always feel like figuring stuff out.
I can understand why you want to go free, because you're not actually
the sock pattern.
I was just going to say, you just use the stitch pattern, because you have your own toe, you have your own heel.
So I don't want to spend money on a sock that tells me how to knit their toe and their heel, and it's just not, unless it had a really elaborate, like,
lace design
or something that I really wanted the charts for, which I probably wouldn't do because I kind of like just doing these plain socks.
This is your third sock?
This is my third sock in 2015.
How many since you really started knitting socks?
Eight or nine. It's been a few. I think I'm going to be able to throw away all of the partially damaged socks in my stash instead of repairing them, because I am replacing them all. But I'm really enjoying this. I love this yarn. Sad Panda is a new colorway from Fiber Nymph, and it's pretty.
It is pretty.
And I like this zigzag pattern. I think it's interesting. It's really easy. You just have to keep moving it over until you get to the end, and then you start moving it backwards. Like, you don't have to pay attention at all. It's very, very mindless. And it's just a 1/1 cable. It's traveling cable. And you can do that without using a cable needle. You can just cable it on there. So it's very, and I don't, like, because I'm doing this stitch pattern on my own sock that I always do, I don't have to have a pattern with me. I really like that. And I can just carry it around wherever I go. In fact, most of this I knit at the hairdresser yesterday.
Oh, good.
I think all, like, 3 inches of this I knit at the hairdresser because I was knitting. So that's the second thing. The third thing I have on the needles.
Oh, that's right. I forgot about
is
that.
Is my Hitofude cardigan.
I love the color.
Yeah, I do too. It's pretty. I've gotten 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I am just finishing my 7th repeat.
How many stitches across is that, out of curiosity?
200-something? 210, maybe?
All right. Not much different than what I did.
No. So, This is for the sleeve, though. It's hard to explain. Okay. It has a unique construction. This will ultimately become the sleeves, and these will become the cuffs of the sleeves.
Oh, all right.
It's going to, like, it's like a shrug. Remember when Lara made that shrug?
Yeah.
So I love how it's coming out. And if you look at it, it's quite, I've knit quite a bit if you just pull it out so that it's
Now, who's doing this? Tara?
My friend Tara, my friend Becky.
Having an impromptu knit along.
And another friend of theirs whose name starts with a K, but I don't know her. I just know her from the internet. So it was like four of us knitting it. And she, the girl who starts with a K is like way ahead. But I think that's going to be really pretty.
I
love this color. This is Enchanted Knoll Farms sock base in Margaritaville. And it's gorgeous. I love these colors. This color green is one of my favorite colors of green. So, and I have, I'm on my first ball. I still have like half a ball left. I had, these were the ones that I had to wind into a million tiny balls.
Oh, you're using those first?
No, I'm saving them for the end.
Oh, all right.
I'm hoping I won't need to use some of the really small ones.
Okay.
And I actually put in a, message to Josette because I want her to dye me another one of these if she can, as a backup, mm-hmm. you know, just in case I because I probably lost quite a bit of yardage in that one that the cat it chewed apart. The cat chewed apart one of my balls. It's not good. So that is on the needles. I knit quite a bit on that yesterday.
Oh, good.
Yeah, I had taken my sock with me to the hairdresser. And when I came home, I put it on the bench in the front room, and then I went into the living room, and I was watching TV, and I was like, oh, I'm too lazy to go get it, so I worked on that. That's how I knit, folks. That is how I knit. So that's it for my dance card.
All right, I have several dates to read, and the reason is because I've been stuck up at home. I'll explain more on that. So, the first thing I have, which was on the dance card last week, is my lined beanie hat by Heather Kinney of Fiberista Files or Highland Handmaids. So this is the finished product. I'm not quite 100% finished with it because I do want to tack it down. So this is what it looks like without the beanie lined. And this is Cascade 220 with some scraps of patterns, 100% wool. But I really love this color, and my son loves the hat. I love the stripe. I think I got this, I modeled this after one of Heather's projects that she had done. I like the stripe
because
it's more
too.
Green. This is the finished one of Zachary's. I brought
They're
him out.
Cute.
That one's already tacked on.
It's a nice hat.
It's probably a little big, but it's definitely warm, and this winter we definitely need the warmth.
Yeah.
And I think this is going to be my go-to hat for any gift giving because, again, it is a nice warm hat.
Well, that doubled edge makes it nice and warm around your ears where you really do need that extra
Well, because
warmth.
When the wind blows, you can actually feel it. Like when I brought this one and I brought this one I made years ago. I can feel the wind go right through this because
it's not doubled,
although it kind of is here.
Well, yeah, where you did the... See, now, this hat looks good on you. This
well,
hat not
this is
not
missing
look.
Some things that I had put on.
Yeah.
It's missing its braids because somebody took them off. Well, just because he's like that. But this was a while ago. But these are my finished hats. I like them. I really like them. And the fact that, you know, he likes them.
Yeah.
My son likes them a lot. So... That makes me happy. As long as
yes.
you're happy, I'm happy. And I love this hat. I love it. It's so simple and mindless. It really is.
You
can make it your own.
You can. You could, you could put any color work design on that you wanted to.
There are some that shown it. And the good thing about this is the inside, you can really use as scraps.
Yeah.
Like I did here. I used scrap black here. I used scrap gray. I was doing blue, but I took it out because I wanted it outside instead of the other color. And I really like that these... work well together. They're both heathered.
Yeah.
They work really well together. But yeah, you can make this hat completely your own. And I really, really love the Kitchener stitch on the top.
Yeah, that gathered top.
It gives it a nice finished look.
And it keeps it from being like, this has a very rounded top, which is not flattering on
me.
Yeah.
That hat doesn't even look right on you.
Wait, is this even the right way?
I think so.
Whee!
I know. I feel like
I'm like a little Dutch girl.
I feel like I should be a pilot with that because it reminds me of a pilot.
If it could only button up like this, look how cool.
No, I don't think
I'm gonna
so.
Design a hat that has little Dutch girl wings on it like this.
Yeah, good luck with that. Yeah.
I'm gonna call it Little Dutch Girl.
But with this winter weather that we've been having, they've been taking every hat they could get because they've been going out and in and yeah. when it was cold or wet.
Well, related to that, do you remember when I first met Sheila? Do you remember when I knit that skull?
Yes, hat with the cotton that I still have in stash.
Yep, that yeah. had Egyptian cotton lining, like band.
Yeah,
and for my husband who wouldn't wear it because he was afraid that this guy that he was trying to avoid at work would think that he played Dungeons and Dragons or World of Warcraft or something
like
and like start up a conversation with him. This is what my husband told me. I think he just doesn't like the hat. But guess who's been wearing that hat every single day? My son.
Really?
Loves that hat.
Oh, good.
Yeah, so he's been wearing the skull hat.
Well, that's good. And I'll mention what my future projects will be in a little bit. It has something to do with something similar to that in the sense of whatever.
So two lined beanies are your...
Well, I finished one, but I just never showed it because it was actually being used.
Yeah.
So my next one, I didn't even cast on, well, I haven't been on air in 2 weeks, but I cast this on, I think, Friday. It's the Gradient Wrap, and it's by Elizabeth Smith, I believe. I just want to get it up because I'm pretty sure that's who, yeah, by Elizabeth Smith. So this one only has 16 projects done, including mine. So this... I love this. This was gifted to me, and I apologize. I didn't get a chance to pull it. Yeah, there we go.
It's pretty.
Look up who gifted it to me, but it was a gift to me by a viewer, and I really appreciate it. So actually, this is the bottom, and I started with the red and moved up to a blue and green. I was hoping for a little bit more of the green,
but
it didn't work out that way. This is all I have left, and the reason I have this hat is because this is part of the same yarn here.
So you've gotten two really good projects.
And I could get
it.
A third.
Yeah.
I'm not sure what, but I could get a third out of it. And so this took 1.5 skeins of the Patton's worsted classic wool.
Mm-hmm.
And then it's called for 60 yards. So the pattern called for 60 yards of 3 different colors. And you do 5 stripes of each color. This is a pay-for pattern. I didn't do that because I had such a nice gradient
yarn.
Yeah,
you don't really need to.
I really didn't need to, and I really love. I was getting so excited when it was almost done. I'm like, one more colored stripe left. And this had a lot of stitches on. For me, it's a lot. And the thing I like about this, too, my goal this year was to do new techniques. And this technique is picking up. And so I had to pick up stitches here and do a 2x2 ribbing on it. So
this one is the button holes.
The button holes, yeah.
And that one's the button band.
So I don't know. How did I do? Is
that you did a good job. Like? That's what it looks like.
And
did you use the rule of thumb where you pick up like
3 for every 4?
Yeah, yeah. Whatever it was.
I just picked up what I could go. What I did do is when I was doing
you did a good job. It looks good.
Doing classes, not even classes, but a knitting club through Fabric Place. They had told me that when you're picking up stitches, to at least break it in half. And then if you wanted to do it another half so that you have points. So I knew at half point I had to have at least 33
That's
stitches.
That's what I do.
Way it's easier. The first time I picked this one up, I took it out like 3 or 4 times until I got it right. It is forgiving to a point in here.
Yeah.
But what was happening is, like, for this one, I had picked up far too many that I had like 10 extra stitches. And, but
I'm going to tell you a secret. When I pick up stitches, a lot of the times I look to see, like if I was doing a button band with buttonholes, what I would do is I would just pick up the number of stitches that felt comfortable to me that worked out for, say, I needed to have this kind of a ribbing. I'd want to make sure I had the right like it ended on the, like it was an odd, an even number or whatever,
right.
You know? And then I use a button calculator to figure out where the four things go so that I don't have to pick up, like I don't have to pay attention when I pick up. And for that, the other side, I would have just been like,
making sure that you match that side, or
I would just make, I probably wouldn't have even made sure I matched that side because you're not really going to notice it.
The only thing I have to say, and I'm not sure if I did this right, and I'll have to look over. So you start off with the ribbing down here.
Yeah.
And when I reached up to the ribbing here, it had me start on a different rib. See it?
Oh, yeah.
And I don't know if that was my error in reading the pattern or if there was an error in the pattern.
I don't think it makes a difference.
It doesn't really make a difference, but if I was to do it again,
you'd
I would make it,
match. I would
just,
too.
But so I might have buttons in my stash because I was looking over at Blue Moon, and my first club shipment way back in 2012 gave me buttons for the project. I just got to find them. They're silver buttons. So, but I really like this. It's I don't know. We'll see how to wear it. I say it's for me, but you know. I need to block it, though, because I want these to kind of stretch out just a little bit.
Yeah. It came out good, though.
Really love it. And, you know, I could this is definitely big enough for a sweater.
Yeah.
So, I like it. I was so excited when I finished it. So, new technique for me is picking up and knitting basically a button band.
Cool.
That's basically what it was. And doing a larger project.
You know, I'm thinking it's so weird, but then I realize I've knit a lot of sweaters where you pick up for the button bands all the time, so that's why I do it all the time. Like,
right.
And you haven't really knit a sweater with the button bands,
no.
So that's why you, it's not really many other occasions where you pick up.
Except for gussets, and it's not
right,
the same thing.
Right, it's not
thing.
The same.
So yeah, because the other thing too, I wasn't sure, the project didn't have you slip a stitch when you were... I'm not sure if that's how it is. I mean,
I think it's easier to pick up if you slipped a stitch on the edge just because it's really obvious where you do the pickups. Because then you can pick up every slip stitch.
Right.
But you don't have to. A lot of times when you knit a cardigan, you don't do the slip stitches. You just pick up.
Yeah. I mean, this was my first project that I was doing that. So I was trying to follow it by pattern. And I really, really love how
it came
out
great.
And, for some reason, I want to have the red up top and the green up bottom. I don't know why. I don't know if that would be the best way to wear it. But I love the feel of the wool as well.
Yeah, it came out nice. And that was out of Unknown Wool.
No, I thought I had it listed somewhere, but I don't.
It's called Gradient Cowl.
Yes, it's Gradient Wrap Cowl, I think, is the official name on it. By Elizabeth Smith. And... currently, there's only 16.
And they use Patton's and Mystery Wool.
Patton's and Mystery Wool. And Wendy will tell you, this is different for me because Feel the Twist compared to...
I know, it's almost like a single.
It is
a single.
No, it's not because you can see
it's
a two-ply.
But it feels like a single.
Feels like a single, where this one is, I think, a four-ply.
Yeah.
It's got more
Patton's
of a twist.
Is a good workhorse.
It is a really good workhorse wool, and I just love the feel of it. It almost reminds me of, like, a fisherman's sweater with the ribbing and stuff like
pretty.
That. So I'm all excited.
It came
and then,
good.
Then I have a small little, making fun of this. So we're having an impromptu with some friends of us, Blue Moon Knit Along.
Yeah, the people who aren't doing Hitofude are doing a Blue Moon Knit Along, which is
so,
pattern of your choice.
So just teasing, because I've been craving to knit certain things, but not necessarily with my Blue Moon. And I had some scrap Blue Moon, and I made this, which it's Earbud Cozy by...
I thought you made it up. It's
an actual pattern by Mary Keenan. And it's a free pattern. It's basically a toe-up, but it's less stitches.
It's pretty.
Or actually, it's cuffed down, believe it or not.
Did you make socks out of that yarn?
I did.
I recognize it.
This is my yarn that I found, I think, under the bed, and it had gotten eaten. And
yeah.
I kind of just, yeah. So it's an earbud, and I think I have something sticky on this. These were in my bag and some maple syrup from work, you know, those little individual spilled on it, and I thought I cleaned it off. But so these are in my bag, and when I was doing some dinner last night, I found these. I'm like, oh yeah, I want to, oh yeah, I gotta clean this before I even.
Gross! It's covered with syrup on the end. Yeah, don't put that in your iPad.
I gotta clean that before. I need to clean that. So I found them, and I'm like, I need something to throw in. So you just throw it in here and throw it in your bag, and that way it doesn't get caught up.
You could even have done like a yarn over row and made a little pouch out of it if you wanted to.
It's 2x2 ribbing. They called for 2x2 knit through the back ribbing, twisted stitch, and I'm like, there's no need for that.
That makes it too stretchy, I would think.
I don't know. Of course, I cast on kind of tight, but so that's a little finished object. It's cute. Just, I wanted, you know, just something. I wasn't quite ready to knit something else, I guess. I don't know.
Well, I have a PhD. I don't have an FO. I have one finished sad panda sock. It looks so pretty. The other one's getting there.
I know.
But I think it came out really nice. I love the sock yarn. I love this base. It gets so super soft when you wear it too. I have soft kitty in this base. So,
oh, that's right.
I'm working on this. I'm going to get it done. And then I decided that... I think I'm decided what my next sock yarn is going to be.
Right, so. You want to just jump into Whirlwind Romance first.
I got to do that. So, but I think I decided what I'm going to do next, but I don't know what sock I'm going to knit next, so I have to think about that.
Well, this you didn't know until basically the toe is knit, right?
Yeah, I wanted to see how
the stripes... Now, are you matching the stripes? You are?
No. I don't care about matching the stripes. Not even close.
Oh, no, all right.
Not even close. Yeah, that doesn't bother me if the socks are different. But I did mirror
that image. Bothers you,
that bothers me. That is my thing. If it was the same way on both socks, it would drive me nuts. So that's it for my PhD. Whirlwind Romance. I have one thing. I got my clue. I love this bag. This is my Stitched by Jessaloo bag that I use for my cross stitch. And I have a Notions pouch that matches it. Makes me very happy. So I got the second clue for my Storytime Classics project. And I was so excited that I finished it right away. The pattern for this month was The Secret Garden.
And do you know what the next... story time is, or you don't know?
No, until you don't know until month. You get it. So okay. There she is in front of the garden door with the little robin on her hand.
Is it 3 or 4 o'clock cross?
4.
So I noticed this is done. Is that part of the clue because of the green?
No. What happens when you do cross stitch is you have to find the center of your cloth.
So that's your center. Okay.
And then I had to work my way up until I got to the first frame. So the center is right here.
Okay.
So I worked up to here, and then I worked around here, and then I got to the pink frame. And now I can just work from this. I don't have to deal. So, but no, that's why I have that random thing.
Because I noticed it on someone else's thing as well. I think it was Sarah.
Yeah, Sarah. I beat Sarah this month. I was kind of surprised.
And Jess, congratulations for finally getting on there.
Well, she was still doing the other one. I think these are so cute. This is going to be for my daughter, and she's really excited about it.
Has she showed any interest in learning how to cross stitch?
No, she likes knitting, and she's not really into needlework. She sews a lot. She likes sewing, hand sewing, but she hasn't really been interested in this. I like this. This is like a nice downtime for me.
Well, it's nice that, like you said earlier, that you have this one clue and it can get done within a couple of days. Now, the next clue isn't until when?
The end of February 28th, it'll be. So I have, so now I can put this aside for a whole month without worrying about it.
What about that part?
Oh, that I just work on a little bit whenever I need a break, I work on the heading. I'm about a third of the way done with the heading.
So besides the heading and the frames for each, is there anything else?
No.
Okay.
The pattern came with all of the frames, so if I wanted to, I could go through and do all the frames in advance. But for me, I'm like, I'll just do the frame when I do the picture, and I'll do it all at once. And I like how each frame has a little emblem from the story. Like the this is Alice in Wonderland has the little glotch.
Clock. Yeah.
And this one has the key to the secret garden.
I don't think
gate.
I've ever read it.
Oh, it's one of my favorite books. I was really excited that it was Secret Garden. And I can't wait to find out what the next story is going to be. So that'll be fun. And my daughter, this will be for my daughter's bedroom. And she's, like, excited every month, too, to find out. I don't tell her what it is. I just
Until
let her, like,
done.
I work on it and she tries to figure it out. Yeah.
Now, has she read The Secret Garden?
Yes, it's okay. One of her favorite books. She's also read Alice in Wonderland, so.
See, I got boys.
I know. Although, honestly, my daughter likes books. Like, she liked Call of the Wild. I hated that book when I was younger.
Oh. See, Max has read a couple of... My ankle's a little sore.
Keep coming.
Max is more into the sci-fi, so he's read Ranger's Apprentice. He just finished reading the whole Maze Runner series. It's more of the sci-fi he's into, and I'm not. I've never really been into sci-fi, and the only reason why is because I can't pronounce the words in my head to some of those sci-fi things. You know what I mean?
Well, Lily's really into manga.
Yeah.
And okay. I find manga to be...
Annoying.
Yeah. I don't understand. I'm sorry for the manga lovers out there. I can't get into it.
Yeah,
I find it annoying to read. I find it annoying that you have to read the book backwards. I find it annoying. I find the characters, the way that they're drawn, annoys me. It's just probably an age thing.
No, my husband loves reading them. He's been reading a series online for a very long time. He keeps just going to the chapters. But anyways... I know.
Not
and Zachary,
for me.
We're just happy that he reads anything.
Yeah, Jack too. If Jack reads actually, the back of a cereal box, we're like, yeah, good
no,
for you.
No, Zachary's been reading a lot. He's been reading Monster High books.
Oh, he likes Monster High.
He does.
Well, Jack, there are books that Jack likes, but...
See, that's the key, is trying
reading
to get him
is
into
on
it.
The bottom of the
yes.
list of things that he would be interested in doing.
Yeah, Zachary as well. That's like last, you know...
He would rather be, like, building with
Zachary
Legos
will or... color or draw or do anything else before...
It's like his bottom level thing.
Where my thing is reading and knitting at the top level.
Okay, yeah, me too. Future dates.
So, future dates, I'm always usually about the yarn first. Very rarely am I about the project. This gradient one was a combination of the both.
Yeah.
So, I don't know exactly what I'm going to, after these socks, I had started a pair that's over there, the blue ones.
Mm-hmm.
I have one sock done. I have to finish the other one. And it's not because I didn't want to. I think I just picked up some Blue Moon. That's why. It's, I want to say Claudia. No, it's not. What's the sample we got from the project? I can look it up. Anyways, I want to finish that because we happened to pull it out. I was
Isn't
pulling out a
the,
needle.
Isn't that the String Theory?
No, it's not String Theory. It's Miss Babs.
Miss Babs. Oh, that's right.
Yeah, the Miss Babs. It was my first try at the Fish Lips Kiss Heel. I'm doing a light blue for the tone, a dark for the for the other one. And I pulled it out yesterday because I was using, I think, the needle for, I don't know, something. And I forgot I really liked it because I did a longer cuff with ribbing. And I'm like, oh, yeah, I really like that. I want to get that done. So I want to finish that. But, so my husband says to me on... Friday, because we had a lot of snow. When did we have snow? Sunday, Monday? I don't know. We had a lot of snow. I couldn't do anything about it. But he goes to me that we need more ski masks.
Oh, yeah.
And so I'll probably just grab out a stash. And what I did with my ski mask, I don't happen to have one on me, is I knit the Jekyll and Hyde pattern. And it's a fun pattern. Well... It's a spooky pattern, and I knit it, and I probably can't find it because I don't think I have pictures of the ski masks. I knit one for my husband.
Yeah, I remember that.
Sure, where is it?
It would be down quite a ways.
Is it?
It was like the first year I knew you.
It was before Zachary's... Anyways, it was a Jekyll and Hyde. Somebody had knit... I don't do the actual pattern because I'm sorry. This is what the Jekyll and Hyde looks like. It's two eye holes with face, and that's somebody made a panda out of, which it's cute, and you can convert it into a hat. So I borrowed, it's a free pattern, I borrowed the whole concept where garter stitch here, ribbing on the neck, and mm-hmm. then the ski mask, I just made one eye. One solid eye. And I like that pattern. Again, it's mindless. You do the, and then I like the decrease on top. So that's what I'll probably do with just scrap yarn. Or I might buy some like Lion Brand woolies, which is washable. So I want to do that, but I need to boost up some socks because I've got a couple holes.
Uh-oh.
Yeah, some of my older ones.
But I'll put some of my new ones right here. My salt and stall socks.
I'm wearing some tried and true only because I'm wearing some cotton ones. I think your mom made these for me.
Oh, yeah.
Because I have a sock in my boot and it's kind of rough on it.
Yeah.
So, but yeah, I want to do some more ski masks. That may not happen until the summer because we have three, one for each of them.
Yeah.
But, you know, my husband wants more and I can't, you know, as much as I'd like to say I'm a knitting machine, I'm not that. Although, if I have the time, I go pretty good. But yeah, that's all I have really. It's just some more, I want to finish some more socks. I need to boost up my socks. I'm wearing them out.
Yeah. Well, I had the disaster, so I need to come back.
Well, mine I just wear, you tend to wear your favorites. And obviously those, like my, the other one that I found a hole in the bottom of it was my barbecue zombie.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, I like those. And a couple of my blue moons. So.
Well.
I got to get moving. It's not like I don't have enough sock yarn.
My future date, I am going to knit with my tumbleweed yarns. What do they call it?
I don't know.
Sugar skull sock yarn, self-striping. It's really pretty. I didn't bring it with me because I don't want to carry it.
Is it something I've seen?
Yeah.
What colors?
It's got like turquoise and pink and
green
or I don't know. It's bright colors.
Oh, all right. All right. Sure. All right. Yeah, I know what you're talking about now. The sugar skull.
Yeah, I forgot that I had it and I saw it on my stash and I was like, oh, I should knit with that neck. Something really bright and
crazy. I'm definitely going to be knitting with some of my blue moon because there's a lot that I like. Yeah.
So, that's it for future dates.
Bobbles and bling. I got some bobbles and bling.
Me too.
If anyone who watches us is a member of the Blue Moon Fiber Arts.
Look away.
Spoiler. A fair enough warning here. So that was my guilty pleasure this year. I joined the Blue Moon Fiber Sock, whatever you want to call it, Socks That Rock, for a couple of different reasons. It's their 10th anniversary. I had some extra cash, which I'm kind of regretting now that I used it for that, but only because I could always use the money elsewhere, but... Oh, okay.
What is that?
It's a 10% code for these stitch markers, which I might actually use. So the first club shipment is Feeling Groovy, which I love. It reminds me of tie-dyed, but not as vibrant. When I first saw it, I thought it was vibrant, but when I... Because I'm one that we get... It's different this time. So last year, I guess they started it where you get the PDF files as soon as basically she ships it, you can get it digitally.
Right.
So the PDF file shows the project or the colors of the sock. So this is what it looks like skeined, reskeined. Is that how you call
re-skeined,
it? Reskeined. Yeah. And it's feeling groovy, and I don't know what to do with these yet, but I'll figure something out. This is what it looks like, not reskeined, and it's really. Actually, that's a pretty good
depiction
like of
it. Sheila showed me the PDF picture, and I thought it was ugly.
Yeah, because
when
not
I see
bright,
it in real life,
it's really
I love
not
it.
Bad.
I, think it's
I don't
really
know what it will be knit up because that's half the. I don't want to say half the problem with Blue Moon. That's what a lot of people complain about. Is
it
really
looks beautiful
hard.
In the skein, and then when you knit it up, it might be a little variegated.
And this is supposed to be medium weight. Does that look like medium weight to you? It looks really thin to me.
Yeah, it looks like medium weight.
Mm. But I love the colors. Ooh, it smells good.
No, it does smell good.
And one of the prizes that we got with it is these little stitch markers, which they're called Floops. Floopstitchmarkers.com. And apparently I got a discount code to it, which I will probably use because I like these. Nice for little socks. And I do use markers sometimes for my socks, depending on what the project pattern is. So this is my, this is called Feeling Groovy, and there's a saying inside it. I just never open them up because I never want to, oh, it's bug in a rug. There's, I guess we're having a contest, like a Jeopardy, and all of them are like bug in a rug, pig in a blanket. There's just certain, they're all something in something. Whatever the sayings are, you know, like a pig in a blanket, bug in a rug.
I don't get it.
I don't know either yet, so.
Oh, something's going to happen?
Yeah, this she's doing prizes and stuff. So the reason,
Slub.
Yeah. I didn't think they were supposed to have slubs.
No, you can never.
Well, this isn't a mill end.
I know, but it happens.
Anyways, the reason I joined too is because it's the 10th anniversary, and these are supposed to be exclusive to club members only forever, ever, 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 ever. So if you're not a club member, you will never be able to get this, supposedly. 405 yards, medium weight. I don't know what will. This will probably just go and sit and marinate for a while. Like my other stuff. I don't
like
know.
The other 500 skeins you have.
I know. But it may not. It's nice and bright. That might actually be a good thing to cast on next.
Yeah, it's very pretty. Very it springy.
It is very pretty and, it, you know, very vibrant and, like you said, springy. So that is one of my items. The other item I purchased, and I saw this on Instagram, and it was in, I don't know who I saw it from, but it was one of those on Instagram, you can check out people, and it shows you people who have similar likes, or people I'm following who might also be following these people, and it was called the Sock Ruler. And at first when I saw it, I thought it was telling you the size of the foot, which would be kind of cool, too.
Right.
Like, you know, this person wears 7.5, so you knit up to here or whatever. But it makes more sense that it's not. This is actual inches, half inches, quarter of inches, which I think is great. You fit it into your sock, and it tells you how much further you need to go. So I know I have to go to 8.5 inches for my son's sock, so I am just about at 7 inches. And, you know, it might be, I'm stretching it a little, but it's nice. You don't have to fuss around with the tape measure. This fits for both toe up and cuff down. It gives you directions on how to use it inside here.
Inside, there's some instructions.
Oh, here it is. I'm like, I know I had it.
I didn't take mine out of the, Sheila got one for me, too.
Yes, I got one for Wendy. Patent pending. And if you are interested in it, they're hopefully going to be having a baby and child size ruler soon. But it's www.sockruler.com. And it has instructions on how to measure if you're doing cuff down and how to measure if you're doing toe up.
She had to tell me about this because I was going to buy one when I saw hers. I was like, I'm finding that website.
Yeah. So if anyone is interested, it is the Sock Ruler. And you can reach her, thesockruler@gmail.com. It's Denise Ilmanen. Easy to use, no tape measure blues. Denise Ilmanen, founder and CEO.
It's cool.
So I'm using it for these socks. I mean, obviously it's not as compact as a ruler, but it's a very sturdy plastic.
Well, and all of my sock bags will fit this.
Yeah. This is a sturdy plastic. It's not going to bend or break. And on Instagram, somebody mentioned that you can use permanent marker and maybe say, you know, right now say, I know for toe-up socks myself, I knit to, I think, 7 inches just out of, I can write 7 inch before I start the heel with maybe a fish lips kiss heel. Or I can do, say, 5 inches before I start my gusset if I'm doing a gusseted heel. Stuff like that.
So I have mine. I knit to 7. And you can see. I want to give a little negative ease. So I have just a little bit more to do before I start. I like
and,
that.
It was nice.
I like how you can make it have a little negative ease by pulling it out.
Right. And the other thing, too, is, I mean, not, again, that a tape measure isn't good, but this you can put in the sock. and you can fool around like this would be a toe of a sock. I mean, obviously not as wide, but you can, you're not fussing with it as much as like
trying smoothing to put it, out.
Exactly.
Yes.
And the other nice thing, down and smoothing it out.
She was saying is you can put it in the heel of the sock to measure the leg if you need to measure your leg for something.
Going up. Like
going
if,
up.
Yeah.
When you do toe
or,
up.
Or better yet, like on the second sock, you're doing, how far did I do go before I started the ribbing?
Right.
Oh, I went 6 inches before I started the ribbing and 2 inches
and
of ribbing.
And you can use it to
and
measure
and it's just
your
so much easier.
We can just show you.
Yeah.
So if you wanted to measure the leg, you just slide it down into the heel. And that
you know
tells
that
you
did,
where your leg was.
What, 8.5 for a total leg?
Yeah. And that's just right in the heel. And I think that's so clever.
It is. I like it. And we'll see how it works.
Thank you. I love it. I'm so excited.
So if anyone's interested, it's thesockruler.com. Patent pending. It was $9.99 plus shipping. And I thought it was reasonable. I mean, I don't know. It was a little bit of a spur of the moment. I saw it. I wanted it. I purchased it.
I would abide it. I would abide it.
You would abide it?
I would abide that. I was going to. When she showed hers, I'm like, I'm buying that right now. She's like texting
don't.
Me, don't buy it. I got you one. I'm like, okay, because I was like on the website.
She goes, I knew it was going to happen. She goes, where'd you get that from? Oh, never mind. I found it. I'm like, don't get it.
I'm like, that would be perfect for me. I can just keep it in my sock bag with my sock.
Yeah, because you usually only do one sock at a time.
I do one at a time, yeah. So it's perfect. So, yes, thank you very much. I'm very excited.
Oh, you're welcome.
So this is my baubles and bling. I don't have any other baubles and bling.
I think that's all my baubles and bling. I have baubles and bling, but it's not something I wanted to purchase. Sorry. Is that it?
Feeling groovy.
Feeling groovy.
And sock ruler.
So check them out.
Sockruler.com.
This was not a gift to us, so this was a purchase. So I'm not doing anything.
Yep, it's totally awesome. As soon as I saw it, I'm like, I could really use that. That would
I think
be
I don't
perfect.
Know how new it is. Like I said, I saw it on Instagram. Before I purchased it, and then I started again on Instagram yesterday.
I just
yesterday.
Like how it's like shaped like that, so it's easy to
measure. The toe of the heel.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That's a good idea.
Yeah.
I love it.
And it's accurate. We did check it just in case.
We did. After my issue with the Chinese
tape measures,
I have to check everything.
It's just weird because on a surface like that, that inch looks really big, but it's a true
it's
inch.
A true inch.
It's just... Looks
I was
really
telling
big.
Sheila with my Chinese tape measures that the inches are like...
An inch and a quarter?
I don't know. They're just like... Somebody who's never used an inch ruler, like, came up with the idea of what an inch might look at, like, from a picture, like, not with measurements. And it's only in increments of 10. You can tell that whoever designed the tape measure is not somebody who lives in a world where we use standard inches. They're probably...
Metric.
They're probably metric, because the metric side is fine.
That's
so
fine.
I told Sheila I have an app on my phone that I've been using called... Converter Plus, and I can enter in any of those measurements, meter, centimeter, yard, foot, inch. I type in the measurement, and it, like, my foot is 7 inches, so I'll type 7 inches, and then it converts it to centimeters, 17.78. So I've been knitting 18 centimeter feet, so I can measure it with my tape measure. Like, I just that's why I have this app on my phone. But this will save me having to do that every time. Although now I know 18 inches.
That's still funny.
But, yeah. So, that's it for Baubles and Bling. Gossip and Innuendo. Oh,
no. Crushes and Heartbreaks.
Oh, yeah. Crushes and Heartbreaks.
So, obviously, my heartbreak is I wrecked my ankle. Not bad. It's throbbing right now, but that's probably because it's been down.
Yeah.
I slipped and fell at work. And I didn't think anything of it until a nurse said, you need to file an incident report. And I filed an incident report, and they told me to go to the emergency room, and I went to the emergency room.
She works at the hospital, so that
I
was
do.
Not a
yeah.
big deal.
My supervisor took me to the emergency room. I felt like such a fool. I think my pride was hurt more than anything. And it said that I had chipped a bone, and I needed to follow up with a
Orthopedist.
So I followed up with the orthopedist the following day.
That was why we didn't record last week, because she had to go to the orthopedist. Yeah.
And I wasn't, and it was snowing, and I wasn't going to hobble.
Yeah.
So they said I sprained some ligaments, and I needed to keep off my foot, which I've been doing. I am home. I am on workman's comp, which I'm not happy about. I'm not one to, like, to sit home. It's been difficult for me to stay home and deal with everything. But I've been trying my best to stay off, and I've been doing pretty good, obviously, because I got some nice knitted projects done. That cowl wrap was most of my knitting. So, yeah, that's my heartbreak. My crush is my husband. I don't know if this is a crush. Is going away this weekend. It is and it isn't, because I do love my husband dearly. I do love spending time with my boys alone.
But it's nice to have a little break, you know, from anybody.
And he's going, he's having a boys' weekend, which I'm really glad.
Yeah.
Because he needs one. He's going out to Vegas to meet up with a couple of his friends and my brother. My brother lives in Arizona, so he's going to meet up with him. And he's meeting up with his friend, Jamie, that he doesn't get to see. They talk online almost every night. They play games virtually, which is great. I'm so glad that they can do that. Our friend Jamie lives in Kentucky. He is in the Army. So he moves around. No, is he in Kentucky now? You know what? I think he might be in North Carolina.
Yeah.
I don't think he's in Kentucky anymore. That's how much they move. They move like every 2 years or so. And then his friend, who also lives in Arizona, a friend from high school, was our best man at our wedding. So I'm really glad that he's getting to do this, because it makes me feel better when I go away for the weekend.
Right, that he's having some chance to.
He is. He doesn't do it often as much, obviously, as I do, because all of our friends are fairly local compared to his.
Right.
Aren't.
We can go on a lot of our things by driving.
Right, right.
Much less expensive.
So I'm excited for him that he's going. I wish he'd go a little bit longer, in the sense, just to take some time. He's leaving tomorrow and coming back Sunday. But he gets to see Penn and Teller. They got tickets to see Penn and Teller. And I'm a little jealous, because I love Penn and Teller. If anyone doesn't know Penn and Teller, they're a magician comedy act, I guess. And they have a couple of series on TV that are really good right now. They're trying to find, like, the next best magician. They're really good. I just love Penn and Teller.
Jim and I were given tickets to see Penn and Teller downtown when we got engaged.
Oh, nice.
By a friend of mine, yes. We went with him, and it was awesome.
They're going to enjoy it a lot. And he's just going to have fun. So I'm really excited for him. And my boys and I get to spend some time together. Not that we don't anyways, but we're going to see a movie and probably go out to dinner tomorrow. Maybe we'll get those new chairs and I can lounge back.
Those are awesome. Go to Woburn.
Yeah.
Woburn has them.
I don't want 3D, though. I don't like 3D movies. It just doesn't appeal to me. And we're seeing SpongeBob.
But they have them in the
I really don't. I know. I know. But we're seeing SpongeBob. I know. But
I don't like 3D either. I find it to be pointless.
Well, Zachary, I don't think, has the attention span for 3D. He's getting a little bit better, but I don't know. To me, 3D is a waste of money.
For a long time, my son didn't have 3D vision because of his eye problem.
Oh, yeah.
And he would just take the glasses off and he'd be like, it's all blurry. Because he didn't have 3D vision at all.
That's funny.
But since he's had his corrective surgeries, he has 3D vision now.
I don't know. I'm glad that we're getting to go out. And so I'll be dropping him off at the airport tomorrow. Oh, yay.
Yay.
So I'm glad I got some rest now, because apparently I'm not going to get rest anymore. And I'm hoping to go back to work for a couple of days next week, because I need the money. Workman's comp is only 60% of your pay.
Well, it's better than
nothing. Yeah. I agree. Well, it should be better than nothing, because it wasn't my fault.
That was an accident. That's what it's for.
I know, but it's still kind of frustrating dealing with this stuff. Anyways, that's basically my crushes and heartbreaks. Oh, one other heartbreak, the snow. I'm done. It's been a week?
We have like four feet of snow in 2 weeks. Not even a week. It's been like in 10 days.
Okay, so you know how you have patio tables with umbrellas? Our umbrella is still up. So what's a patio table? About 4 feet up?
No.
3 feet?
Three and a half.
And then you have the umbrella. Yeah. And the snow is up to halfway up our umbrella. Granted, it's probably stuff from sliding down. But I have a stockade fence that's 8 feet. It's 3/4 up.
The problem is that it's been this light, powdery snow. So not only do you get, like, we literally got, like, three, feet of snow on top of a foot of snow. But then the wind blows it around, so it, yep. it like gets these giant drifts. Like, we have a drift that's up to the windows in my porch.
Oh, I don't doubt it.
It's like taller than my head.
And supposedly we're supposed to be getting another storm.
Apparently,
Sunday and Monday.
I was told that within the next 10 days, maybe not all in one day, but we're going to get another 2 feet. That's what I was told. Another 2 feet.
Well, the good thing on part of that is we taught Max how to snowblow with our snowblower. And I'm very grateful for that because I can't go out there. And my husband's not going to be around. Max, we had some leaking on our roof. And Max was on our roof. We have a very... The way our house is situated, we have a high roof here, and then we have a lower roof here, with the which is the addition, mm-hmm. and the water is leaking in between the shingles of the house down into our roof. That's what's causing these problems.
Yeah.
It was an addition, and whoever shingled them didn't do a very good job. Something to do with the flashing. I don't know. But I'm very grateful that Max is as old as he is and as big as he is in the sense that he can do the things that I cannot do.
Yeah.
So I'm grateful for that. My husband paid both of them a decent amount of money for helping out the last storm.
That's good.
No, obviously Max got more because he did more.
Yeah.
But still.
Our kids have been helping to shovel because our snowblower does not work all the way. It works until it gets down to a certain temperature and then it won't start. It needs to be serviced.
Is there any way you can bring it in? Or?
Well, Jim's going to try to find a place to bring it in this weekend before we get another 2 feet of snow.
So, I would suggest there's a guy straight up the top of my street. That's where we had our service.
Yeah.
That's too far for you guys.
Yeah, there's a couple places locally that'll do it. He'll find someplace. It just needs to be cleaned and serviced. We meant to take it in August and we just didn't. We it's one of those things where we should totally take the thing in now. And then we just spaced
Something else
it.
Came up.
Yeah. And so he can get it to run. But then if it gets really icy, like tonight, we're supposed to get down to 18 below, it won't work because it jams up and it's because it needs to be cleaned out. So hopefully we're going to get that done.
Okay.
My crushes and heartbreaks, my crush is that I got this sock thing. This is the only good thing that's happened to me in a week. This is the highlight of my week, people. I have been sick just about every day. Since I started taking that tamoxifen. My daughter has been sick, so it could be a bug. It might not be a symptom, but I literally, every day, I am sick for at least part of the day. And I've noticed that if I don't eat until the afternoon, it's better. So I've been trying to do that. Today I've only had water and iced tea. I haven't eaten anything. I'll eat at lunchtime and... Seems like my stomach is more upset in the morning right after I take that medicine. So I don't know if it's related or not, but you get sick of being sick for that long. I'm tired. I've barely eaten anything because almost everything upsets my stomach. The other thing, heartburn.
Mm-hmm.
I never get heartburn. Never. I never do. The only time I've ever had heartburn was when I was pregnant. I have had heartburn every single night. And I think it's related to my stomach problem, which could be a virus or it could be this medication, because apparently some people also have this kind of symptoms. So I don't know. But other than that, I feel fine. I haven't had any weird hot flashes or anything scary happening to me. It's, I just piled it in the, stacked it on the pile of the pills that I have to take every day. I have a granny pill taker thing. So it hasn't really bothered me that much. So that's one heartbreak. My other heartbreak is that my treadmill was supposed to be delivered on Sunday. If you go in the group, there's a story about it. It did not get delivered because they screwed up. But they wouldn't admit that they screwed up. They accused me of lying. I want to make it clear that this is the delivery division. The people in the actual customer service division.
This is Sears.
That's Sears. The customer service people were all very friendly, and the sales people were all very friendly.
Good.
So, but I don't have a treadmill. My husband and I went to Walmart last night to look at another model, but very similar, to see how big the box was. We brought a tape measure. It might have fit in my CRV if we put the passenger front seat all the way to the front, and my husband laid down in the back with it. And Jim was like, I'm not doing that. And I said, I agree. And even then, we might not have been able to shut the back door. And it's just, it's very icy here, and you just don't want to mess with a giant 200-pound thing in the back of your car with the hatch open in this weather. So we have two options at this point. I can order it from Amazon, and they will deliver to my house, and it will get here at the end of the month. Or we can buy one locally and rent a truck for $20 from Home Depot, which I think is what we're going to do this weekend, because the $20 truck rental is way cheaper than shipping. Delivery. And shipping is free on Amazon because I have Amazon Prime. So the shipping, but the delivery service from Sears was $79 for delivery. And I said to Jim, you know what we should do is rent the truck for $20, drive to the Sears, which is like 2 minutes from my house, pick it up in the truck and bring it home. And he's like, yeah, so we might do that this weekend. Because I told him that I want to have some kind of control. And that feels like I can control when I work out. And it makes me feel less out of control, because taking this medication makes me feel very out of control. And that's a part of my anxiety issues. But it's just like, it will just make me feel like I'm also doing something to stop myself from getting cancer.
Mm.
So those are my two heartbreaks. And I guess my third heartbreak is my kids missed 2 days of school last week from the first blizzard. 2 weeks from
2 days.
2 days this week from this blizzard. Next week they have 2 half days coming up, Wednesday and Friday. And if we have snow Monday, Tuesday, they'll miss more. And then the week after that is February vacation.
Oh, that's right.
Which is another reason why I am going crazy, because my kids are in the house and they play outdoors and they help gyms. They've been shoveling and everything with Jim. But it's when it's really bad and snowy, they don't want to play out so much. Their neighborhood kids that they usually play with
want to come in.
It's just, yeah, it's so I'm like, I can't take it anymore. I just want them to be in school. So that is my third heartbreak.
Yeah, my kids have been wanting to have the kids come in, and I have not been in any mood for that.
No, it's messy. I've been sick. That's the other thing. I've been sick.
Well, that's the thing.
So
it's
want to have kids around when I'm not feeling well, in case I have something that I'm going to give them.
Well, mine is I just don't feel like, because I'm lying on my couch. I've been sleeping on the couch because they said not to use stairs.
Yeah.
And it's like, you know what? I don't want to feel like I have to move my stuff around to accommodate them, because our TV and our couch is in the same room. This is our family room. I could have used the futon, but right now it's got laundry on it.
Yeah. It's just, you know,
I don't want them in the house
right
now.
And I don't want everyone tracking all that salt stuff into the house, because it's a mess to clean up.
Yeah, see, most of them would.
So, you know, my kids, it's been hard to keep them entertained. You know, they go out and play in the snow, but then they come in and they're like, what do I do now? And I'm like, I don't even know, because we've been trapped in the house for days and days.
Normally we limit our computer and TV time, but it's been to the point where you can't.
Then what else are you going to do after a certain
They can read
point?
And, but you know, you can only do so much that, you know, me personally, I like having the TV on for background noise, whether I'm reading or knitting. It's something like, I love Alaskan State Troopers. I love that. So
my
that's
mom
been on
loves
the,
that one.
That's been, it's their last season this year. That's been on the TV, and it's just mindless so that I can not even pay attention while I knit or I read, but I need background noise. I don't know why. I always do.
Well.
But yes, the kids in the house is driving me insane.
Yes. And knowing that I'm going to have them for a whole week, we've had to push Jack's birthday party back until March because.
Yeah.
February is the worst month to schedule a party
really
because
is.
Of the snow, and then we have vacation. Two of his friends are going to be gone when we were going to plan for his party. So, gossip and innuendo. Number one, multiple people told me this. Stitches East is not happening this year.
It's been canceled.
It is not scheduled, and it may come back next year, but I don't know. And I had heard that there was a question about whether they were, where they were going to have it or what they were going to do. And I have to say, the attendance at Stitches East was very poor the last 2 years, and I totally think it's because it's difficult to get there when they shut all the streets around the convention center down for that marathon.
But good news for Texas. Apparently they're having something in Texas instead. That's what I hope for.
Score.
Yeah.
So I'm kind of relieved that there's no Stitch Disease this year because it's like one less thing that I go to. Because if it was in town, I would want to go to it.
No, I mean, I know. I like it. Yeah, but, I just don't even bother.
But I'm like, ooh, that's one less thing I have to do in October. So, or November. October and November. It's one less festival to do. So I'm excited that I don't have to go to it. So we chose a winner for our knit along for the month of January. Our winner is getting a beautiful skein Knit Cozy Hermione's Beaded Bag. It was a Harry Potter Yarn Club exclusive. It's 80% superwash BFL, 20% nylon, 400 yards, and it was donated by our friend Angelia McGar. It's gorgeous.
I really like those colors.
I do, too. It'd
be interesting to see how that knits up.
It's really pretty. This is going to post number 50, K-Par 62, Kathy, and she made a snuggle, like one of those doggy snuggles.
Oh, yeah.
Or animal shelter snuggles.
Yeah.
And this is coming to you, so text.
PM me.
PM Sheila with your snail mail address so we can send this out to you, Kathy. And thank you for doing the knit along. And
what is it, K-Par 62?
K-Par 62. Congratulations, Kathy. The next thing that we're going to draw for is the Earth's Wonder Collection by Angelia McGar, who fittingly donated that yarn to our podcast. So this is like the week of Angelia.
Apparently.
So anyway, there are six patterns in the collection, and we drew names. We in the order that we drew you, we matched you up with what you wanted until
we couldn't
match people up anymore. So these are the winners. The Oyster Trees pattern is going to number 63, Barb Knits. Hi, Barb. Congratulations. You'll be getting a copy of Oyster Treasure. Did I say Oyster Trees? Oyster Trees. I made up another new thing.
Yeah, I don't think that one's going
Somebody
anywhere.
Somebody needs to make a sock yarn color called Oyster Trees.
I don't think so.
It would be green and white. And maybe like a little gray. The second pattern, Plummeting Fronds, is going to post number 28, BM Soul Lounge, Bernadette. You are getting Plummeting Fronds. The third pattern, Rolling Brook, is going to post number 32, May 1020. Angela, you'll be getting that. The fourth pattern, Snowy Tempest, is going to number 13, Blonde 20 Fan, Jesse. The fifth pattern, Summer Shadows, is going to number 27, Hot Knitter. And the final pattern, Swash Mark, is going to number 40, Betty for Fiverr. Betty. So I will give all of your names to Angel, and she will send out the patterns to you. So I will do that sometime after we post the show. So I think that's it. And then, the last thing, I'm going to show this right now. And I'll probably stick a picture in at the front of the show, too, because the show is really long. We're doing a new contest where you can win this bag and yarn from Knitting's My Bag. And she has donated three sets. The first one has brightly colored birds and yarn from Knitty and Color. And we're going to put a thread in a contest thread in the group and give you 2 weeks to go for that. And I'll come up with some kind of a creative
thing to put into it.
Question to put into that. For that. But that's the first of three. And I'm going to put a picture of all three of them together right here. So you can see what else is coming up. And we'll be doing those over the next month or so. We may not do them all back to back. It depends on what kind of other contests come up during that time. Because I want to spread them out. Yeah, because they're really nice.
Maybe we can do them one a month.
Yeah, we might do one a month for the next 3 months. So look for that contest too. That'll be posted in the group. And I think that's all we have for this week.
It was a long one, but I had a lot to talk about.
Sheila hadn't been here. Last week's was really short because it was just me. So,
thank you for watching. Thanks for coming back each week. We really do appreciate all of it. Just in case we don't say it enough, we really, really do. So thanks for all of the people who sent their well wishes to me. I appreciate it. I am getting better. It is killing me to sit still. I'm a workaholic at heart, but I will make it through. So thanks for watching. Knit with heart.
Stay warm. Bye.